ಪ್ರದಂ ದೇವಂ ಕ್ಷಮಾಪೂರ್ಣಂ ಜಗದ್ಗುರುಂ ವಂದೇ ಪರಮಹಂ ಸಾಖ್ಯಂ ನಿತ್ಯಾನಂದಾಯ ಸ್ವಾಗತಂ. ಜೀವನ್ ಮುಕ್ತಿ ಪ್ರದಂ ದೇವಂ ಕ್ಷಮಾಪೂರ್ಣಂ ಜಗದ್ಗುರುಂ ವಂದೇ ಪರಮಹಂ ಸಾಖ್ಯಂ ನಿತ್ಯಾನಂದಾಯ ಸ್ವಾಗತಂ. ಆನಂದಾನುಭವಾಸ್ವಾದಂ ಸರ್ವರೋಗನಿವಾರಕಂ ವಂದೇ ಪಾಪವಿನಾಶಕ್ತಂ ನಿತ್ಯಾನಂದಾಯ ಸ್ವಾಗತಂ. ಆನಂದಾನುಭವಾಸ್ವಾದಂ ಸರ್ವರೋಗನಿವಾರಕಂ ವಂದೇ ಪಾಪವಿನಾಶಕ್ತಂ ನಿತ್ಯಾನಂದಾಯ ಸ್ವಾಗತಂ. ನಿತ್ಯಮುಕ್ತಂ ನಿರ್ವಿಕಲ್ಪಂ ಧ್ಯಾನಲೋಕಪ್ರದೀಪಕಂ.
ಪರಮಹಂಸ ನಿತ್ಯಾನಂದರು ನಮ್ಮ ಯುಗದ ಒಬ್ಬ ಅಭೂತಪೂರ್ವ ಆಧ್ಯಾತ್ಮಿಕ ಶಕ್ತಿ, ಅಂತಾರಾಷ್ಟ್ರೀಯ ಆಧ್ಯಾತ್ಮಿಕ ಸಮಾಜದ ಆಂದೋಲನದ ಸಂಸ್ಥಾಪಕರು, ಆಧುನಿಕ ವೈದಿಕ ನವೋದಯದ ಪ್ರಥಮ ಅನ್ವೇಷಕ, ಪವಿತ್ರ ಊರಾದ ತಿರುವಣ್ಣಾಮಲೈನಲ್ಲಿ ಜನ್ಮ ತಾಳಿದ ಒಬ್ಬ ಯೋಗಿ, ಕೆಚ್ಚೆದೆಯ ಆಧ್ಯಾತ್ಮಿಕ ಸಂಶೋಧಕ, ದೈವಶಕ್ತಿಯ ಮಾರ್ಗದರ್ಶಕ ಜ್ಯೋತಿ, ಪರಮಹಂಸ ನಿತ್ಯಾನಂದರು ಇಂದು ಪ್ರಾಚೀನ ರಹಸ್ಯಾರ್ಥ ಯೋಗ ವಿಜ್ಞಾನದ ಪಥದಲ್ಲಿರುವ ಲಕ್ಷಾಂತರ ನಿಪುಣರಿಗೆ ಸ್ಫೂರ್ತಿದಾಯಕರಾಗಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಆಧ್ಯಾತ್ಮಿಕತೆಯ ವಿಜ್ಞಾನದ ಸಂಶೋಧನಾಕಾರ, ಆತ್ಮ ಸಾಕ್ಷಾತ್ಕಾರ ತೋರುವ ಗುರುಗಳು, ಅವರ ವಿವೇಕದ ಸಂಪತ್ತು, ಅವರ ನಗುವಿನ ಆ ಸಂತಸ ಹಾಗೂ ಅವರ ಅದ್ವಿತೀಯ ದೀಕ್ಷೆಯ ಶಕ್ತಿಯನ್ನು ಪ್ರತಿ ವರ್ಷ ಪರಮಹಂಸ ನಿತ್ಯಾನಂದರು ಪ್ರಪಂಚದಾದ್ಯಂತ ಸುಮಾರು 1 ಕೋಟಿ ಜನರೊಡನೆ ಹಂಚಿಕೊಳ್ಳುತ್ತಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಈಗ ಪರಮಹಂಸ ನಿತ್ಯಾನಂದರು ಜೀವನ್ಮುಕ್ತಿಯ ಬಗ್ಗೆ, ಆನಂದಮಯ ಜೀವನಕ್ಕಾಗಿ ಪರಿಹಾರಗಳ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಮಾತನಾಡಲಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಮರೆಯಲಾರದ ಆಧ್ಯಾತ್ಮಿಕ ಅನುಭವವನ್ನು ಕೈಗೊಳ್ಳೋಣ, ಬನ್ನಿ.
ಸ್ವಾಗತಂ ಸರ್ವಧರ್ಮ ಪ್ರಣೇತಾರಂ ಸಚ್ಚಿದಾನಂದ ರೂಪಿಣಂ ವಂದೇ ಸನಾತನಂ ಪುಣ್ಯಂ ನಿತ್ಯಾನಂದಾಯ ಸ್ವಾಗತಂ. ವೇದ ವೇದಾಂತ ಸಂವೇದ್ಯಂ ದೇವದೇವಿ.
All of you, every day becoming old. Nobody wants to listen to this word. But the truth is truth. Every day you are aging. Even biology says, every day some parts of your body is disappearing and new parts are getting created. Once in 365 days, your whole body is completely replaced. Every cell is replaced. Not even one cell remains as same after 365 days. But you don't feel the suffering of discontinuity from childhood to youth and youth to old age. Understand, it is not only in the physical level, even in the psychological level. You are not the same person who you were at the age of 25. You are not the same person who you were at the age of 7. Child is not youth. Youth is not old man. Old man is not, old man was not youth, and youth was not a child. But you don't feel the suffering of discontinuity. You don't get perplexed by this change. Why? Because the percentage of change is negligible than the percentage of continuity. What you feel as you, with what you identify as you, in that the percentage of change is lot less than the percentage of continuity. You feel you are body and mind, So in that, the percentage of continuity is more stronger. The percentage of change, very negligible. You need to know an important fact, even after your so-called death, for 3 months your hair and nail continues to grow. That is why whenever the jiva samadhis are created, they have the habit for till 3 months they will open again and shave it and cut the nail. When the masters leave the body in jiva samadhi, means they just keep the body and the samadhi is built all around. They don't fill the samadhi with any other material, just body is kept. So the samadhi is opened and cleaning the hair and cutting the nail is done for next 3 months. Body is constantly changing, mind is constantly changing, but you don't get perplexed by the change, because what you feel as you, in that only 0.0027% change is happening. If you feel one hand is broken or one leg is broken, you get perplexed, because the change is too much now. It can be even 3% to 4%. See, when you are having bigger changes, you do get perplexed. So now the formula, the sutra, the truth, sacred secret, if you awaken your inner self, means if you understand with a simple understanding, you are not just body, mind, you are body, mind and spirit also. Many translators go on translating, you are not the body, you are the soul. You are body also, you are mind also. But when you realize you are consciousness also, you are Atman also, the percentage of the body and the percentage of the mind becomes negligible. It is like a, you have a vast space. When you shift your cognizance about yourself, when you shift your understanding about yourself, when you perceive your higher existence, even the death and birth is like everyday night falling asleep, morning waking up. Unfortunately, human beings were so deluded. Human beings are so ignorant and deluded. Now, even every night sleeping and morning waking up has become almost like a death and birth. Gita is saying, let your death itself become like a sleep and waking up. But ordinary ignorant mind has gone to the level, even the everyday sleeping has like become like a death. There are so many people who can't even sleep. Understand, the cognizance you take about yourself is the root cause of all the joy and suffering you go through. Understanding this one verse has so many practical utility, value. You will not bother about the discontinuity. If the fear of discontinuity is removed from the human mind, millions of sufferings we go through will be removed. The other day I was reading an article by a professor who works in the line of world peace. They are evolving a theory called one world government. They are saying each country is spending their huge resources on army and maintaining their border, boundary. If all of us stop spending so much of energy into the army and protecting our boundary, they are saying, if those resources are diverted towards creativity, betterment of humanity, forget about removing the poverty, like giving human beings basic food, medical care, clothes, health, shelter. Forget about these ordinary five basic needs. They say so much of our resources will be spent in different directions, like we can do so much research on longevity, we can do research on life on other planets, we can do research on so many lines, so much of breakthrough can happen, almost we can become eternal, we can become immortal. So the picture they tried to paint is just we all merging together and standing up as humanity can do so much good to the whole humanity. We can provide food, clothes, shelter, health care to the whole humanity, and thousands of breakthrough in different fields in research and development. So after reading the article, I felt, wow, sounds really great, and almost they are painting heaven on the earth. But now I wanted all of you to know, now I want to tell you, much more than that, much more than the decision of one world government, this decision, imbibing this truth and teaching this truth to the world, means the truth of continuity. If we can make the world understand there is no discontinuity, this can revolutionize the whole universe much more than the concept of one world government. This can revolutionize the whole world, whole human civilization, much more than one world government. Because when the understanding of continuity happens, when all the fears and insecurities related to discontinuity disappears, you can see in front of your eyes, our perverted desires to hold wealth will disappear. Our insensitivity to all the crimes we are committing. If you can save yourself from law, you think you can do anything. Sometimes people do that. But when the government changes, that's it. But I tell you, if you realize the truth of continuity, there is no discontinuity, you will understand everything you accumulate. You may not answer the law, but you have to answer the cosmic law.
Shivena vachasa tva girishaccha vadamasi ಯಥಾನಸ್ಸರ್ವಮೆಜ್ಜಗದಯಕ್ಷ್ಮಗುಂ ಸುಮನ ಅಸದ ಅದ್ಯವೋಚದರಿ ಭಕ್ತ ಪ್ರಥಮೋ ದೈವ್ಯೋಷಗೆ ಅಹೀಹಶ್ಚ ಸರ್ವಾನ್ ಜಂಬಯನ್ ಸರ್ವಾಶ್ಚ ಯದುತ್ರಾಣ್ಯಃ ಅಸೌ ಯಸ್ತಾಮ್ರೋ ಅರುಣಪುತ ಭವ್ರಸ್ವ ಮಂಗಲಃ ಯೇ ಚೇಮಾಗುಂ ರುದ್ರ ಅಮಿತೋ ದಿಕ್ಷುಶ್ರುತಾ ಸಹಸ್ರಶೋ ವೈ ಶಾಗುಂ ಭೇಡಯೀಮಹೇ ಅಸವ್ಯೋ ವಸರ್ಪತಿ ನೀಲಗ್ರೀವೋ ವಿಲೋಹಿತಃ ಉದಯನಂ ಗೋಪಾ.
It will continue. I tell you, every good quality you acquired in the inner world, every bad quality you acquired in the inner world are going to come with you. So don't think by dying you can escape from any of that. No. Life is imprisonment. You are caught. Nothing can be done about it. I am telling you the straight truth. The only thing we can do about it is unclutch and understand your consciousness. You are trying for freedom with wrong understanding. Change of place does not lead to freedom. Change of inner space leads to freedom. Continuity is the law. Even if you die, there can be thousands of realizations, freedom from thousands of problems. The moment you understand the truth of continuity, now look and try to analyze your concept about health. Build it based on this concept of continuity. If I do heavy yoga now, the health I accumulate, the muscle memories I accumulate, the bio memories I create is going to continue with me forever. Same way, if I start unclutching and practicing unclutching for next few months, after that, even if I forget this few months, what I made is going to live and continue with me forever. If I accumulate some bad qualities, the negative engrams, I cannot save myself from it. It is going to continue with me forever. Somebody told me that I wanted my last check to bounce, Swamiji. Means, at least in the last check he wants to cheat somebody. Because he can't be caught anyhow now. You can't make him answerable now. He would have been dead. I tell you, no. That fellow will come back again. Small story. One man, rich man, was in deathbed. He is too attached to his money. He calls his doctor, his priest and the lawyer. Gives each one of them $1 million. Tells them, please put this cash in my tomb and bury me when I die. I may need for some expense when I go up in the heaven. After a week, he dies and the whole ceremony is happening. First, the priest comes. He hides the money in a small bag and brings it because he has brought only $500,000. $500,000 he swallowed and he just dumps the $500,000 into that pit in which his body is kept. And slowly, doctor comes. He also keeps only $500,000. Lawyer comes and checks. And he says, you immoral fellows, you have no respect for your word. See me. He he collected both half a millions and put a check for $2 million. But I tell you, the guy who died is going to come back to collect the remaining money from all the fellows. He is going to come back to take half a million from priest, half a million from the doctor, and remaining 2 million from the lawyer. Nothing is going to discontinue. Everything continues to exist. To the detail of your experience, if you have felt money plays a major role in your life, that will continue after your death. If you feel your spiritual struggle plays a major role in your life, that will continue after your death. If you feel your relationships are important experiences in your life, that will continue even after your death. You will be associated with the same group of people again in some way till you realize the truth, till you experience the ultimate, till you liberate yourself. Continuity happens in all planes. Only when you have inner awakening, when your kundalini is awakened, when you realize, when you take the right cognizance about yourself, I tell you, if you the moment you take the right cognizance about yourself, that you are body, mind and spirit also, immediately kundalini awakens in you and body starts levitating. Just this understanding is enough. You can try, just try to remember in your inner space, I am body, mind and something more, maybe conscious or spirit or the energy which makes me function. Suddenly the rush of energy, even the understanding, can give you the experience of levitation. Nothing else is required, just the understanding. Just as the embodied one goes through tenderness of boyhood, bloom of youthfulness and infirmity of old age in this body, in the same manner it takes on another body. The awakened one who knows this does not get perplexed. Millions of your sufferings, fears will be reduced the moment you understand. I really wanted to make this chapter of Bhagavad Gita as a syllabus and lesson in all the old age homes to age gracefully and to leave the body gracefully and assume the body gracefully. There are beautiful Upanishadic references on this same truth.
It has 2000 crore loss.
Thank you. expected to reach at least 1 lakh people per day.